Good evening, and welcome to the 162nd graduation ceremony at Circleville High School, the seventh in our new school building and the first ever online graduation. At this time, would everyone please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. To begin on this Memorial Day weekend, I would like to first take a moment to recognize all the men and women who have served and protected this great country we live in today. To all of the veterans, current military, and graduates who will soon be military personnel, we thank you for your service and dedication to protecting all of us who are watching today. I would also like to give thanks to everyone who serves our community, including police officers, firefighters, doctors, nurses, and emergency personnel who in these uncertain times have sacrificed so much to protect our community and our state and our nation. To all these individuals, we say thank you. I have several people who I would like to thank for their hard work and dedication to making today's ceremony unique and meaningful for our seniors of the class of 2020. Specifically, I would like to thank Mr. Jonathan Davis, Circleville City School Superintendent, Mr. Kyle Urig, Assistant Superintendent, and Mr. Evan DeBow, Circleville City Schools Communications Director. I have had the privilege to work alongside these three men the last 2 weeks to create what we believe, given our circumstances, and is an amazing experience to the end of the school year for the senior class of 2020. They have brainstormed, they have been flexible, and they have been 100% focused on creating an atmosphere and environment that will leave a lasting impact on our graduates. Next, I would like to thank our Board of Education for all of their support during this time. I'm extremely grateful to work in a district that trusts their administration and their employees to do what is best for students. No matter what type of adversity we have faced, our Board of Education has supported and allowed us the opportunity to continue to recognize and celebrate the accomplishments of this year's graduates. To the CHS staff, I cannot say enough about the compassion, the dedication, and all of the hard work that everyone in the CHS office has displayed towards our seniors. The work of Mrs. Scott, Mrs. Schooley, Mr. Young, Mr. Spradlin, Mrs. Reimer, Mrs. Webb, Mrs. Bowers, and Officer Hafey has been outstanding and just goes to show how much we all care about making today special for our seniors. The last 2 weeks of events would not have been possible without these individuals. If you see these people out in the community, please tell them how much you appreciate their hard work. Next, I would like to thank all the parents, family members, and friends of our graduates for virtually attending today's ceremony. You are all to be commended for your help and support in getting these young men and women to one of the most important days of their lives. I want to also thank the faculty and staff at Circleville High School. We at Circleville City Schools and our partner school, Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center, have a tremendous amount of dedicated and hardworking and supportive individuals who have helped shape our graduates into the people that they are today. From the time these students first stepped foot inside a building at Circleville City Schools, they have been welcomed with open arms and have been challenged to be the best students and people that they could be. And now to the class of 2020. This school year has definitely been like no other, one that has been full of uncertainty and change. About a month before the COVID-19 virus turned everything, including the education world, upside down, I was reading a book by a well-known author named John Gordon, who writes and speaks about leadership across the country. This book was laying on my desk when our varsity boys basketball coach, Mr. Cody Carpenter, stopped in to see me one day. It sparked a discussion between Coach Carpenter and I, and he recommended another one of his books called The Coffee Bean, which was co-authored by a man by the name of Damon West. About a week later, I came into my office and Coach Carpenter had dropped this book into my mailbox, so I decided to read it. Never did I imagine how relevant and impactful that this short 91-page book would be not only for me, but the class of 2020. If you get a chance, I highly recommend that you read it. But to summarize the book, it uses the analogy that life is often like a boiling pot of water. It can be harsh, stressful, and a difficult place at times. In life, you will find yourself in environments and facing conditions that test who you truly are. These things can change, weaken, or harden you if you let them. But the best part about it is that you have a choice. Over the last 2 months, I believe every senior listening tonight would agree and can relate that life has been harsh, stressful, and difficult. Whether it was missing out on your senior prom, finishing your high school classes online, or not seeing your friends and teachers, or missing out on a traditional graduation. Many opportunities for memories and many of the traditions of a typical school year were lost. All of these events and disruptions have been out of your control. But during this time, we have all had choices to make. We could dwell on the negativity that this has caused, or we could blame others for the problems and complain about the environment and all that is taking place. Or we could transform the environment around us. This is where the story of the book titled The Coffee Bean comes into play. Think about this for just a minute. If you would take a coffee bean and place that in a boiling pot of hot water, what happens? The coffee bean does not weaken, it does not become soft or change for the worse. Nor does the coffee bean become hardened by the boiling water and become negative and angry like some people may have been tempted to do given our circumstances. The coffee bean transforms its environment by changing the boiling water into a cup of coffee, something completely different that is satisfying and enjoyable. The senior class of 2020 did not let the challenges that we've been faced with define us. They've changed their environment. Working with members of their class, we were able to add some new traditions, such as the senior banners, the senior yard signs, and the senior graduation parade. Each of you completed a 9 weeks of online courses that better prepared you to be independent learners by learning about time management, self-paced lessons, and for some, the effects of procrastination. For those of you planning on furthering your education, you have a head start on what it is like to take online classes and what it takes to be successful at these courses. For those of you joining the workforce, you are all now better prepared for the changes and pressures that your jobs or careers will present to you. You all persevered through the changes in the environment that were in front of you. Instead of letting your environment weaken or harden you, you transformed your environment just like a coffee bean transforms in boiling water. For this, it shows me that the class of 2020 is well prepared for the next stages of your lives. Class of 2020, I personally have enjoyed getting to build relationships with you and wish you the best of luck in all that your future holds. My door is always open, and if there is anything I can do to help in the years to come, please do not hesitate to get in touch. Again, I leave you with the challenge to go out and transform the environment that you are presented with. Be that change agent that impacts your environment in a positive manner, just like a coffee bean. And now I would like to introduce our superintendent of Circleville City Schools, Mr. Jonathan Davis.
Good evening. I want to start my speech this evening with a huge thank you to the essential employees and our first responders who have spent the last few months keeping us safe. If one of these awesome folks is in your home with you right now, please thank them for us. To our military men and women on this Memorial Day weekend, including those, as Mr. Thornsley referenced, in the class of 2020 who are enlisting. Thank you doesn't nearly seem enough. The sacrifices you've made have benefited us all, and I hope you know how much we appreciate you. I'd also be remiss if I didn't take this moment to share my adoration for the staff here at Circleville City Schools, including the Board of Education. This event has caused many changes to daily life, routines, and traditions, and not one time did our team complain. They simply asked how they could help our students, especially what they could do to honor the class of 2020. Our staff is awesome. Thank you. To the parents and family members of the class of 2020, this day is as much about you as it is about your student. I say this as a parent of an 11-year-old and 9-year-old. Just raising a child is a difficult task in normal circumstances, and what you've been challenged with is extraordinary. We want to commend you for the amazing young people you've raised, and thank you for the opportunity to play a part in their life. I hope you are able to enjoy today. You deserve it. Now, to the class of 2020. I'm guessing every graduation speech this year will be on the commonality of adversity in your upcoming adult life and the encouragement to make this a part of your story. You're going to be told that life isn't as much about the event as it is about the response you have to those events. They're going to challenge you to remember what you took for granted before this time, and they're going to implore you not to do the same in the future. They are 100% right. You should listen to them. For the sake of not being repetitive, though, I'm going to briefly take a different path. When I was 24 years old and 2 months before I was to marry the love of my life, I was diagnosed with cancer. I was a first-year teacher at Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center, and my life seemed to be going great until that fateful Saturday morning doctor's appointment. To hear the words, "you have cancer," directed at you shakes you to the core, unlike many other things in your life. I never thought it would happen to me, especially at 24 years old. The first few days after that appointment, my common thought process was, why me? Why now? And I tell you that story not to depress you, as I'm prayerfully 15 years cancer-free. I tell you that story because that event in my life helped me to understand the importance of certain things, especially during difficult times like now. And I suppose some of you have had similar thoughts over the last few months. Why me? Why us? Why now? That was the most devastating and difficult time in my life up to that point, but it taught me one of the greatest lessons I ever learned. Immediately upon my diagnosis, there was this team of people who surrounded me. They loved me through the entire thing. They were my parents, my in-laws, my wife, and specifically one of my best friends. They never left my side. They attended every radiation treatment, and they stayed at my apartment. They didn't let me be alone until they knew I was healthy enough, mentally and physically, to be. What's my point? Times of chaos reveal the true character of us all. In that chaos for me, it was revealed who cared for me the most, who loved me, who literally sacrificed for me. These were my people. This left an indelible imprint on me, and it has inspired me to live my life in such a way that I can do the same for others. I ask you this evening, who are the people that through this time truly have been there for you? They've done all they can to encourage you, to make you laugh, and to get you through. And in reverse, who were you supporting during this time? Look around and recognize what your family and friends have done for you, not only in this time, but leading up to graduation day. Who are your people? As I've gotten older, I've found the importance of true and lasting relationships. You see, the folks I mentioned at the beginning, who are informing you that this event is just an example of the difficulties life will throw at you, they're right. But the difference for you is that you've been trained to respond in the appropriate way, as well as you have an amazing group of people to surround and love you through anything. I know this because I've seen it happen over these last 9 weeks and during your time at Circleville City Schools. Remember that. Don't forget it. And remember that in the future, some of these people will need you to do the same thing for them. I'm extremely proud of you. I'm excited to sit back and watch the amazing things you're going to do in your life. And never forget, if you need anything at all, please don't hesitate to reach out. We are happy to help. We're happy to be your people. Congratulations and go Tigers.
And now I would like to introduce our salutatorian, Abigail Michael.
Good evening. First, I would like to thank the entirety of the Circleville City School staff, all the parents and other family members, and the class of 2020. Now, giving my speech to a camera and an empty gym is never how I imagine this day, not how any of us imagine this day. However, instead of focusing on the negative, let us focus on all the positives. For starters, we aren't stuck in a hot and crammed gym. We don't have to sit through an entire ceremony, and I don't have to worry about occasional disruptions amongst the crowd. We are also the first graduating class in history to have a special and virtual graduation ceremony and a senior parade throughout our community, which essentially means we are the coolest graduating class ever, but everyone already knew that. We have such a variety of outstanding individuals, and it has been an honor to experience this all with you. Although graduation marks the end of our journey here at CHS, we will always be Tigers. Not all of us started here in Circleville, but throughout the years we have become family. We are all celebrating and getting through this together. The class of 2020 has made history in many ways, and loads of memories have been made this year. Our boys' golf team qualified for districts last fall. The football team beat Logan Elm. The girls' basketball team were district champions. The girls' bowling team were mid-state league champions, and the marching band qualified for state once again. Those are just a few of the amazing things that our class has accomplished. Our lives have been surrounded by changes, the biggest yet being due to the coronavirus outbreak. But even during this pandemic, we persevere, just as we always have when unprecedented events occur. This is just another challenge that we must face until we reach the other side. On September 11, 2001, when tragedy struck our nation, many in the class of 2020 were just born or our parents were expecting. We were born during the tragedy of 9/11, and we are now graduating during a global pandemic. One might say we just have bad luck, but I feel as though our class has truly learned that life is unpredictable. The saying, "Don't take life for granted," could never be more true than it is now. Along with thousands of other seniors, our spring sports seasons, proms, last day festivities, and what would have been the greatest last 2 months of high school were taken from us. As devastating as it is, I am thankful to be standing here today, as COVID-19 has taken the lives of people in our own community, two of which were closely related to two of our classmates. Shay Ford lost her great aunt, Sherry Patterson, and Helena Hassett lost her father, Robert Dean Hassett. I ask you all to join me in a moment of silence in remembrance of their vibrant personalities and for all of the other lives lost. Thank you. The uncertainty and fear that we all fear is normal. Times are rough now, and life will still be unpredictable after 2020, but I am confident that we will come out stronger. Our graduating class is complete with outstanding individuals heading on all kinds of paths. People going to college, I am proud of you. All of you going into the military, I am proud of you. If you plan on working full time, I am proud of you. And even if you aren't sure yet, I am proud of you, and so is everyone else. It's okay to have different paths than the person next to you, as long as you do what is best for you and you enjoy it. So I challenge you to write your own success story, to test the limits, and work hard for what you want so that when you get to the top of the mountain, success is waiting for you on the other side. The class of 2020 will be remembered as a class full of buoyancy and perseverance during a time that shall never be forgotten. To my classmates, good luck on wherever life leads you, and thank you for all the times we had together. I wish you all the best, and remember, success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. Thank you.
And now I would like to introduce our valedictorian, Peyton Perini.
Good evening to the class of 2020, our friends and family, staff and administration, and the Circleville community tuning in to watch this video. I want to begin by thanking everyone who has made this day memorable for us seniors during such an unprecedented time. We would have not made it here without the support and guidance we have received from the amazing teachers, coaches, and administration here at Circleville City Schools. I encourage you all to say thank you to any person here at Circleville City Schools who's made a difference in your lives during your past 4 years. It's an absolute honor to be able to stand here right now and carry out one of my greatest dreams by sharing some words of encouragement during this time with the friends and classmates I grew up with. All of our lives, we have been anticipating our senior years. We've been waiting for those last moments with childhood friends for the past 18 years. Last first day of school, last home football game, last band and choir concerts, the last time we would stand in the student section cheering, last game we would plan, last pumpkin show break, last day of school, last prom, and the day that validates our hard work over the last 13 years, graduation. While as a class, we were fortunate enough to get to experience most of these things together, the spring of our senior year was taken from us. However, we still got to experience most of these things just a little differently. We still got to have our senior pancake breakfast, just not like we imagined. We were still able to have our senior prom, just virtually. Today, we are having our long-awaited graduation, just a little less traditionally. Over the past 4 years, we've made amazing memories and grown as individuals. We will not forget about all of the times Coach Bigham dunked on people in the hallway, the many hot days we spent sweating in Everett's Middle School, Anthony Favre and all of his Favre jokes, celebrating with the football team at Logan Elm after a hard-fought win this past season, playing hack attack in Miss Hackworth's class, Miss Lombardo and her pink dumbbell weight, having to get peso points in Miss Z's class, having Fire Fridays with Mr. Lamb and Cotton, being told not to look at the eclipse during the school day sophomore year, and risking our dignity and maybe even possibly our lives while competing in the all-important Dizzy Izzy game at pep rallies. We will also not forget all of the times we got in trouble for getting caught parking in the senior lot when we weren't seniors, getting lost while popcorn reading in Miss Tice's class, and for playing with fidget spinners in class freshman year. We will also forever remember the late study nights we had to pull to finish our chemistry 9 weeks projects for Mr. Cotton, all of the assigned vocab definitions for Mr. Beavers, and everyone saying, "This might be bad," before walking into Miss Maid's class when you have a test that day. While it's important to recall the trivial and silly things about our high school experience, we must not forget the impressive accomplishments of some of our 2020 classmates. We've had numerous band members earn ones at solo and ensemble. Abby Travis graduated early to join the military. Andrew Feller received a silver key at the Scholastic Art Competition. Aubrey Smith helped write the first ever Children's Pumpkin Show picture book produced here at Circleville. Maddie Emler and Philip Barth both received honorable mention at the Scholastic Art Competition. Tasha Rice placed in the Governor's Youth Art Exhibition. And Caleb Morgan placed at State in Destination Imagination with this tower creation. These are just a few of the examples of the artistic talent and skill some of our fellow 2020 classmates have. I can't discuss the accomplishments and achievements of our classmates without also recognizing the tremendous athletic success we've had too. Our baseball team made it to the Final Four our sophomore year. Our girls basketball team had an undefeated regular season, making it to the Elite Eight. Sydney Gray broke the school record for the lowest score and for 9 holes in golf. Bree Kendrick broke the single season assist record for girls basketball. And 5 students in our class are continuing their athletic careers at the collegiate level. The talent and hard work of all of the individuals I have mentioned has definitely made me proud to have been their classmate. While I have enjoyed reflecting on the fun times and the accomplishments of our time at Circleville City Schools, I would be remiss not to recognize the circumstances we are all in today. I'm delivering this speech to a camera instead of on a podium in front of our friends, families, coaches, and teachers, a gathering we've all looked forward to for 13 years. That being said, today I am not here to focus on everything we have lost due to COVID-19. Instead, I want to talk about perseverance and determination. As a class, we have persevered through many things in our lives outside of the current situation to make it to today. We were brought into this world during the aftermath of 9/11, and now we are being sent into adulthood during the midst of a global pandemic. I believe that our class will be stronger because of this situation, and it will make us better individuals down the road. Through this time, we have learned to persevere through hard times, to be determined to make the best of any situation. We have learned that life will let you down sometimes, but also we have learned that we can overcome any adversity that comes our way. Looking to our future, life will carry us all in different directions. Whether you plan to go into the workforce, attend college, or serve in our nation's military, after today, we are finally free. We are free to become whoever we want to be. Some of us will become electricians, doctors, engineers, mechanics, teachers, nurses, journalists, and many other things. I encourage you to go confidently in the direction of your choice with all the perseverance and determination in the world. Whatever occupation or career path you may choose, there is a world out there that needs us to make it a little better each day. I encourage you all to set goals, to give back to our community down the road, and to embrace the endless opportunities waiting for us. There will be adversity in our future, no doubt, but I know that we can overcome anything we put our minds to through our unwavering dedication to perseverance and determination. We are strong, we are determined, we are ambitious, we are tigers, we are the class of 2020. Thank you.
And now for the reading of the class roll by Mrs. Shayna Palda and Mr. Jason Beavers.
Peyton Lane Perini. Abigail Nicole Michael. Victoria Elizabeth Goff. Molly Lynn Harbor. Crystal Isabella Miner. Sydney Lauren Gray. Anthony Mitchell Favre. Whitley Annette Calder. Wesley James Hodge. Krista Nicole Simzak. Gabrielle Marie Kendrick. Jonathan Thomas Hemp. Shaylin Lee Ford. Lauren Ray Welsh. Aiden Thomas Lowe. Maya Jane Welsh. Victoria Samaria Sprague. Bethany Allison Tolbert. Alexis Renee Marie Wiley. Aubrey Marie Smith. Anna Michelle Whitaker. Victoria Catherine Bircher. Mackenzie Diane Neville. Abigail May Travis. Kelsey Jean Terry. Caden Graham Burton. Madison Sue Emler. Taylor Kristen Hedges. Savannah Nicole Buskirk. Guinevere Brianne Harris. Jackson Carter Matthias Speakman. Alexandra Catherine Nungester. Tasha Danielle Rice. Caleb Michael Morgan. Connor Austin Jones. Caitlin Marie Cooper. Madison Lydia Hess. Allison Ruth Killam. Sydney Marie McClanahan. Faith Madison Hardbarger. Logan Matthew Potts. Madeline Ann Kluchinski. Alex Paul Turnbull. Sydney Arlene Wickline. Hannah Joe Creech. Brandon Matthew Ward. Megan Elizabeth Davis. Brianna May Smith. Peyton Olivia Speakman. Olivia Joy Reeser. James Shelton Scott. Thomas Jacob Dimmel. Michaela Deanne Smith. Amber Sky Ackison. Ryan Maxwell Allen. Tyler Lee Amon. Taylor Ann Barthelmess. Taylor Lynette Beatty. Elisha Jean Belknap. Austin Bailey Benson. Bailey Don Bavard. Jacob Wesley Bradshaw. Peyton James Brown. Dalton Lee Burgess. Mackenzie Rain Byram. Madison Victoria Byram. Hannah Nicole Campbell. Bailey Jewel Case. Kyle Lee Mad Dog Cassidy. Mark Allen Christman. Timothy Edward Clements. Raquan Antrell Clifton. Gina Nicole Coleman. Macy Lynn Conrad.
Logan David Crabtree. Aubrey Brooke Cunningham. Michael Dale Dalrymple II. Brianna Jordan Davis. Jacob Arlos Deerwester. Aiden Malachi Divini. Selena Dawn Diaz. Sierra Rain Farley. Madeline Joe Fosnaw. Mackenzie Nicole Fosnaw. Hannah Marie Fowler. Santana Monet Dariston Fowler. Rihanna Snow Frazier. Ethan Tyler Gibson. Mason Cole Gilmore. Evan James Graves. Jacob Isaac Greathouse. Robert Craig Griffith Jr. Caleb Michael Giles. Channing Lee Hagler. Marcus Lee Hall. Helena Vera Hazlett. Christopher Dean Hill III. Hudson James Hockingberry. Callie Brianne Wren. David Austin Hulse. Matthew Riley Jones. Ronald Burt Jones III. Mariah Autumn Kemp. Elijah Maxwell Latimer. Gavin Parker Leonard. Carlos Emmanuel Lerma. Aaliyah Marie Marquez. Shelby Lynn Matthews. Noah Elias McCain. Michaela Sky McMurray. Destiny Dawn Miller. Evelyn Rose Morrison. Jaden Verlin Muncy. Scott Lee Myers. Robert Lee Neal Jr. Megan Ann Nicholson. Thomas Aaron Eugene Pack. Brandon Amir Parr. Abigail Lynn Perkins. Amber Marie Peters. Avery Bradley Peters. Michaela Dawn Pummel. Andrew Michael Purden. Haley Rose Rapp. Mackenzie Ashlyn Reber. Hunter Joseph Russell. Kayla Janae Sark. Charles Adam Shaw. Trayton Mark Shrake Blanton. Eric Edward Gavin Schultz. Austin Tyler Schwabaugh. Drathan Earl Levi Schaefer. Aaliyah Azen Slagle. Alyssa Marie Smith. Felicity Ann Smith. Maya Kathleen Smith. Braden Lee Sowers. Lucas Spencer Speakman. Clayton Cole Spencer. Brian Thomas Stanley. Brianna Marie Stonerock. Tyler Dakota Allen Teets. Andrew Thomas Feller. Tiana Angele Thorpe. Drew Allen Vance. Anthony Patrick Wood Jr. Ethan Tyler Young.
And now for the singing of our alma mater by our Circleville High School Symphonic Choir, directed by Cynthia Braswell. And now for the presentation of the class of 2020, please welcome Senior Class President, Ms. Allie Nungester.
Good evening, and I'm Allie Nungester. It is an honor to be speaking on behalf of your senior class. I cannot believe how fast these years have gone by. Many of us have shared these years since preschool, but no matter the time spent together, it was spent well. Our class can think of people and experiences that make the class of 2020 unique. Of them was, of course, the coronavirus. Not only has this virus put a burden on our senior year, it has taught each one of us the value of our family relationships, holding our loved ones close, and also appreciating the small things, like watching sports, hanging out with friends, and most importantly, attending school. Even though my classmates and I began to dread the last few weeks of school, being quarantined has showed us that our teachers, friends, and sports teams are greatly missed. Speaking for the senior class, we would like to thank our administration and teachers for their hard work during these challenging times. I would personally like to wish good luck to my fellow classmates. May you each find joy and happiness in all your endeavors. Lastly, in the words of Nelson Mandela, the greatest glory in living lies not in never falling, but in rising every time we fall. It is my honor and privilege to introduce to you the 162nd graduating class of Circleville High School.
Here we are on top of the stars. Never thought we'd ever get this far. We live for moments like this. We come alive in moments like this. Here we are, this is a time like a dream coming to life. Through my head, I try to capture it, but a picture can't hold what a heart is feeling. I just wanna stop the world from spinning, slow it all down for a minute so that I can take it in. I can take it in. Here we are.
Congratulations to, go ahead, Taylor Ann Barthamus. Congratulations to Mackenzie Rain Byram, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Madison Victoria Byram, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Jacob Wesley Bradshaw, graduate of class of 2020. Congratulations to Savannah Nicole Buskirk, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Amber Sky Atkinson, graduate of class of 2020. Congratulations to Caden Graham Burton, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Dalton Lee Burgess, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Taylor Lynette Beatty, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Elisha Jean Belknap, graduate of the class of 2020.
Congratulations to Victoria Catherine Bircher, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Raquan Antrell Clifton, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Austin Bailey Benson, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Hannah Jo Creech, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Kyle Lee Cassidy, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Logan David Crabtree, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Whitley Annette Calder, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Hannah Nicole Campbell, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Macy Lynn Conrad, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Caitlin Marie Cooper, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Bailey Jewel Case, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Timothy Edward Clements, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Gina Nicole Coleman, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Sierra Rain Farley, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Madeline Jo Fosnall, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Michael Dale Dalrymple II, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Anthony Mitchell Favre, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Santana Monet Dariston Fowler, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Brianna Jordan Davis, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Selena Dawn Diaz, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Thomas Jacob Dimmel, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Shaylin Lee Ford, class of 2020. Congratulations to Jacob Arlos Deerwester, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Heavenly Brooke Edwards, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Megan Elizabeth Davis, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Rihanna Snow Frazier, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Robert Craig Griffith Jr., graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Evan James Graves, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Caleb Michael Giles, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Ethan Tyler Gibson, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Sydney Lauren Gray, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Hannah Marie Fowler, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Faith Madison Hardbarger, graduate of the class of 2020.
Go ahead. This is what it is.
Congratulations to Helena Vera Haslett, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to David Austin Hulse, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Callie Brianne Wren, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Molly Lynn Harbor, graduate of the class of 2020. Congratulations to Madison Sue Emler, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Victoria Elizabeth Goff, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Madison Lydia Hess, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Taylor Kristen Hedges, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Gabrielle Marie Kendrick, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Marcus Lee Hall, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Christopher Dean Hill III, class of 2020. Congratulations to Jonathan Thomas Hamp, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Wesley James Hodge, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Mariah Autumn Kemp, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Gavin Parker Leonard, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Ronald Burt Jones III, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Allison Ruth Kellum, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Madeline Ann Kluczynski, CHS grad, class of 2020. Congratulations to Elijah Maxwell Latimer, CHS grad, class of 2020. Congratulations to Aiden Thomas Lowe, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Connor Austin Jones, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Scott Lee Myers, graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Evelyn Rose Morrison, graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to McCalla Sky McMurray, graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Crystal Isabella Minor, graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Sydney Marie McClanahan, graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Shelby Lynn Matthews, graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Destiny Dawn Miller, graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Noah Elias McCain, graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Jackson Carter Matthias Speakman, graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to our salutatorian, Abigail Nicole Michael, graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Avery Bradley Peters, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Jaden Verlin Muncy, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Megan Ann Nicholson, graduate of CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Mackenzie Diane Neville, CHS graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Aaliyah Maria Marquez, CHS graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Hunter Joseph Russell, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Andrew Michael Purden, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Alexandra Catherine Nungester, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Thomas Aaron Eugene Pack, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Caleb Michael Morgan, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Logan Matthew Potts, CHS graduate class of 2020. Congratulations to Brandon Amir Parr, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Michaela Dawn Pummel, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Abigail Lynn Perkins, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to the class of 2020 valedictorian, Peyton Lane Perini. Congratulations to Olivia Joy Reeser, graduate in the class of 2020. Congratulations to Amber Marie Peters, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Haley Rose Rapp, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Peyton Olivia Speakman, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Austin Tyler Schwalbaugh, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Krista Nicole Simzak, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Mackenzie Ashlyn Reber, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Tasha Danielle Rice, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Brianna Marie Stonerock, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Brian Thomas Stanley, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Kayla Janae Sark, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Aubrey Marie Smith, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Maya Kathleen Smith, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Drathan Earl Levi Schaefer. Congratulations to Charles Adam Shaw, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Michaela D. Ann Smith, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to James Shelton Scott, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Trayton Mark Shrake Blanton, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Alyssa Marie Smith, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Braden Lee Sowers, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Kelsey Jean Terry, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Andrew Thomas Feller, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Lauren Ray Welsh, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Brianna May Smith, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Victoria Samaria Sprague, graduate in the Class of 2020. Congratulations to Clayton Cole Spencer, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Felicity Ann Smith. Congratulations to Tyler Dakota Allen Teets, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Aaliyah Azen Slagle, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Alex Paul Turnbull, graduate in the CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Maya Jane Welsh, graduate of the CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Alexis Renee Marie Wiley, CHS Class of 2020. Congratulations to Sydney Arlene Wickline, CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Tiana Angele Thorpe, graduating class of 2020. Congratulations to Anna Michelle Whitaker, graduating class of CHS 2020. Congratulations to Anthony Patrick Wood Jr., CHS graduate, class of 2020. Congratulations to Drew Allen Vance, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations to Brandon Matthew Ward, CHS class of 2020. Congratulations, Bethany Allison Tolbert, CHS class of 2020.